wir mal Party. I only got a few minutes to record right now. I'm sorry I'm not loud enough, but y'all. Oh, y'all. Okay, so like, check in. Y'all already know, y'all look okay, cause it's a marbly kind. I wanted the little on these two nails. I wanted that little white thing, that little slanted type white thing. But y'all, I'm not even doing that. My steals. I'm playing though, cause I'm gonna mess up my nails. But anywho, that's why I really wanted. But I'm doing it next time probably. But y'all, they're so cute, and I'll be telling you, I'm not gonna be basic anymore. Like, but I really only like designs on these nails because they're a whole different shape. But one day I'm gonna try that little lip that Megan Thee Stallion. Okay, look, this is not the point of this video. Okay, so this was recommended one day. I went on live, somebody's homie. I should do a high school video. Dang, I didn't read the video. What is supposed to be anymore? But it's supposed to be a high school, I mean a freshman type of thing, a video. Oh, freshman advice video. Okay, so yeah, so for my people who will be God. I'm always choking myself. But y'all, school starts tomorrow for like my county. School is tomorrow, so I'm kind of late, but anywho, but anyway, y'all, for the kids, that'll be the people. Did it be one, but it's school tomorrow. And when I say school starts tomorrow, which was actually yesterday, but y'all, like, this is gonna be late. So today that is dropping is Tuesday, and school actually started yesterday, but I recorded this video Sunday. But yeah,
check it. You're in high school, it's your first year. Yeah, I'm so excited for y'all. You really done came a long way, but I'm gonna tell y'all, my ninth grade year was like, even though I'm just going to 10th grade, my ninth grade year was like here and there. Like, it was really good, but then it was like really bad. And then people be like, your freshman year is like one of your worst years. Okay, so I can kind of see what people say. I see what I mean, because y'all, I was like living my best life but failing. I'm gonna be honest with you, I'm gonna be like a whole blunt with y'all. I was living my best life, so I think that's what, like, that's probably what's gonna happen. I mean, I don't know how you operate, but it's like your freshman year is like, they know. I feel like teachers and people know, okay, you just, because I remember like one of my mom had emailed one of, well, one of my and my teacher would email it back and forth, and she was basically saying what I'm gonna say. But like the teachers and everything, they basically know, okay, you just got out of eighth grade, da 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 da, this your first year of high school, da da da, it's new to you. So you're not really, I mean, I don't know if you can like take, cause high school is, you know, when how they be, it's kind of, it gets more serious when you go to high school. It's not as funny games as eighth grade. I mean, cause eighth grade for me was funny games. So, and that wasn't a situation where I was having the best time of my life, but I was passing and having the best time of my life. But when I got to ninth grade, I was still, see, like, you take in from middle school and you bring that into high school. So I think that's like how that works. And the teachers, they be like, okay, fail. But yeah, and they don't really try to help you that much, because them teachers, when they be telling you in eighth grade, we're trying to get you prepared for ninth grade, they really mean that. So, but I mean, at the same time, it's like, I don't understand what they be trying to get you prepared for ninth grade for, because in middle school, you still, it's like you have no freedom. In high school, you have a lot of more freedom, and they don't get you prepared for that. They still, it's like you locked up in middle school, well, eighth grade, basically. But like, they always, we trying to get you prepared for high school, but they don't really prepare you on what you need to be prepared for, like, just talking about, I mean, the essays and da 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 da. You barely do that when you get in. Well, I didn't do that. I don't know about y'all, but who's my ELA teacher? what was ELA called? Because it definitely wasn't called ELA. Y'all, who was my ELA teacher? Oh, it was, no, it was called First Language. First Language, Aiken High, that's what it's called. It's not, I don't know what it's called in the middle of it. I think probably called ELA. But, so, yeah, I really, First Language, it was a really Cambridge class. So, at Aiken High, because I went to two high schools. So, I'm getting to that. But, Miller Valley and Aiken High, oh, y'all. Miller Valley is, let's be honest. Miller Valley is kind of lower than Aiken High. Like, Aiken High is up here. Then Miller Valley is a little. But, like, let's be honest, because we all know that. Because we have all these Cambridge classes. We have a whole bunch of. Think about that exact. Aiken High might have me. But, but yeah. So, y'all, I'm waiting for this timer to go off. But yeah, so Aiken High, we have Cambridge classes. So English was called First Language. And I don't understand why I couldn't remember my English. Who was my English teacher at Aiken High? Because y'all, that was like one of my favorite classes. Because I used to be on my phone. I used to run that class, period. But okay, so So we didn't really do essays in that class. That class wasn't first language. Okay, that class is really not hard. It's not hard at all. All you gotta do is follow instructions. I hope she's my teacher next year. I mean, whenever I go back to school, I hope she's my teacher because my English is. But she was so chill, so laid back. If she's not my teacher, I'm gonna get up. Period. But yeah, the class is so easy to pass. If y'all going to Aiken High, the class so it says, I really can't give y'all so much advice on Midland Valley, but I'm going to tell y'all one thing. I'm going to tell y'all, if you're going to Midland Valley, please keep yourself together, because Midland Valley will try to send you out. I mean, they will be getting new principals and all of that. I'm basically talking like we're going to school, because in my freshman year, I was going to school. So I'm not talking about virtual, like. But keep yourself together, because in Miller Valley, they will set you up to fail. Like, Miller Valley do not love you. Aiken High, they love you. Period. Y'all, I'm going to go check on these croissants, because my timer haven't went off. And I like my croissants to be soft, soft. Even though I put them on for like 12 minutes. But I still like to go check them on. Sometimes I take them out before. They be wrong. I'll be honest, like, my croissants be wrong, because they gotta be soft for me to bite. I don't like that. I don't like them hard. Hard is burnt to me. Like, I don't like that. But I'm gonna be there, y'all. Hold on. Okay. So, yeah, I'm back. But as I was saying, Midland Valley's like, you just gotta stay out of trouble, because, like I said, they will try to send you away. I don't know what Pinecrest at. But I know, like, they got the bus to it or something, or whatever, or the kids be there, or whatever. I feel like because they know they got that. Yeah, they feel like, I never had honey on my biscuit. I eat them with syrup, like, in the morning time. I eat some bacon or something. And I'm eating all eight, because ain't nobody asked for none, and I'm fat. And I'm hungry. Okay. You know my business? Don't do that. But yeah, y'all. So, I feel like because they got their system or whatever. I don't know. I heard somebody say it was like right there. But, right where? I don't know where the Pinecrest would think of thing yet. Because I remember it was in Aiken. I mean, no, this is Granville, but yeah. But yeah. So, I'm telling all my business. Yeah. Yeah, it looked like something was in my drink. I was trying to get mad. But yeah, look. Them. just Minute Maid Tropical Punch. Don't be doing the most. But yeah. What else? Y'all stay dressed up because I'm fine. But since then, you have, I can have five real bitches to like, don't be doing the most. Don't be doing all the itch stuff because you know, they can have you doing the most. Sometimes. Don't be doing the most. Let me just pour it on a plate and dip it because I'm trying to be all too. But yeah, I'm gonna be doing more. What else should I say for freshman advice? Oh y'all, when it comes to dressing up at the beginning of the year, they care. Well, especially they can have, yeah. Well, that's what I heard. Like, I want some holes with I want some pants with holes above my knee. One time, and somebody was like, don't do that because that's dress code, and that Dr. Hope didn't play. Like, I was thinking people get dress code, but then towards the end of the year, they didn't really care anymore. I don't know if that's what Millie liked too, because I wasn't there at the end of the year, but still. Pretty sure that's what all schools at this point. They're just trying to be strict so y'all they get a hold of their rules. Like, it can have their problem is they'll tell you the rules and then let the rules slide. And then you have them teachers. This and honey do not go together. Y'all hate this juice, but I be giving it to the kids because I hate it. And I'm literally gonna go pour it out. I mean, it be good, but like for a couple sips. And then it's mad. And then it don't go with honey. Because honey got that taste, that weird taste, like aftertaste kind of. I don't know the name too. But yeah, y'all. Yeah, you had them teachers that still want to go by the rules. They want to be lame and go by the rules. So then you get in trouble. And you have a whole bunch of students in trouble because now you're getting caught by them teachers. And then the principal would be like, y'all know this is, I don't know what they be saying. But it was like trying to tell you not to forget about the rules. But really, like, they weren't doing anything. But then they see all these kids getting in trouble. Now they want to say something. That's how school be. Y'all, I eat like a baby. Like, I always cut myself into pieces and then eat it like I'm a kid. But when I go get these other folk, I'm gonna pour this drink out because, ew. I'll give me some food too. But yeah. What else could I say? Maybe I should just talk in general. Maybe if I was like older, I would have better advice. I'm gonna come next year with an updated one because I need to compare years together. But I know excuse me, next year I'm gonna be doing a sixth grade advice video because my sister will be going to the sixth grade and I want her to have some, and she watched my channel, so I want her to have something to look at and for other kids. So I have cousins who will be also going to sixth grade right along with her. So something for them to be looking at, you know. Even though I could tell her myself, but still I have other people that looks up to me that I could be telling and helping. That honey, okay, the honey was good for y'all. I am like very picky, so like it's hard for me to try new things, but I could try new things and I can like it for a second and still won't like it. And that's my problem right here. Like this drink, this honey, this why. Yeah, I'm gonna go get my biscuits, but I want to finish telling y'all stuff. But I don't want biscuits to get cold. My croissants. Bill. Okay, so y'all need to stay out of trouble because, well, I'm gonna just like basically talk in general. Okay, stay out of trouble because schools will fail you. I mean, like schools will try to put it, everything against you. People be saying it can help you trying to do that, but I don't really be seeing that. But I mean, to be honest, like I said, I be one of those students that like, I literally be walking in the hallway, really, because that's where a lot of people get caught. It's mainly the hallway. Is where you get caught. It's everybody in the hallway, all your friends in the hallway, da 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 da. You be trying to skip, trying to stay out of, I mean, stay in the hallway longer than they supposed to. That's how you get caught. Like, that's how you really be getting in trouble. So, I mean, like, just go to class. You used to have a little walking buddy. I used to have walking buddies here and there. But you can find a little walking buddies to walk to class with. That's no biggity. I would not recommend sharing a locker. I would not recommend that. I did that in middle school. I mean, I remember, okay, let me tell you what's tea. So, I would recommend that for middle schoolers, but once you get in high school, I wouldn't recommend that because people be so wishy-washy, so messy, so petty. Like, if it's your best friend, I guess, but I still wouldn't even share a locker with my best friend. And especially now we're in high school, you have, well, at Midland Valley, we had those big behind books. So y'all know we had to carry, I mean, keep them things and all. Okay, Midland, I mean, Aiken High, they'll give you them books. They say bump them books. I mean, you could check, but you could say, because people always like, well, my Midland Valley friends, always like, well, how you take books home? You could check books out, but they don't give you them books. I mean, like... And I'm glad because I used to have all that space in my locker for anything. Like, I wanted y'all ever see how in them videos back when YouTube was kind of fun, like you was young, YouTube was fun, and they had them people used to be decorating all their locker up like all cute and stuff. I always wanted to do that, but yeah, I still plan on my senior year. I'm showing out my locker, even though I barely use my locker, like barely. Okay, another thing is. People, one good trick to do if you do use your locker a lot, I know I did this a lot, but I had two lockers at Midland Valley because I was on the volleyball team, so I put I ain't even gonna get into that one, but I'ma still tell y'all. But I used to put my, don't put your locker number and your password. Or if you gonna do that, don't put your if you do that, put your, cause I know where my locker at. I'm good where, when it comes to what locker I have. It's just sometimes I be forgetting a little number or whatever. So, I used to put my accommodation on my lock screen or my home screen, either one. But I'd rather you put it on your lock screen because you tap your phone gonna cut on, you know, just take a little peek. And that's a good way because keeping them little cards and everything, you tend to put your locker number or having them little things they give you, your everything on there. It's like the pen and the number to the, so it's just easy for people to lock it, I mean, get into your stuff. I advise you to, if you, because I do keep mine, but I'm good at keeping my stuff away from everybody else and having people knowing what paper is what and blah, 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 blah. I cannot stand people going through my books, my folders, don't touch my stuff, like, period. Everybody know I don't play that. I don't play them type of games. Don't be touching my book bag, my books, my papers, my phone. Don't do that. be like that. Be that type of person, because people be looking at your paper and you be like, oh, this your password? You got a funny password. No, don't do that. I mean, people, like, they might not have the intentions of, like, logging in to your thing, but I mean, at the same time, you know, because a lot of people get in trouble for that, because the people are logging to your stuff and then they'll do some funny stuff, and that's just too much to be dealing with. Like, y'all, I'm gonna be honest with you, in middle school, like I said, all that stuff is, leave that for middle school. Like, once you get in high school, it's about business, because you don't got no time to be messing up. Like, you don't got no free time to be messing up, because all that goes into what colleges are starting to look for. Like, this is business now, but like all that password, I mean it's like, no, because they changed them. But at one point they don't be changing them like that though. I remember my thing being changed one time. I was so mad when they changed the computer passwords though, y'all. I didn't know a lot, because it was funny because I had been in school all that time, been able to remember that password, but I didn't remember until the year they changed them, y'all. I think that was my 7th grade year they changed the password. I was so mad because, y'all, it took me that long to remember the password already. Then when I finally remembered it, it was like changed, and I was like, I know you lying. Anyway. But yeah, so they had changed the password. But I used to have a friend, I used to have her password, she used to have my password, but it was only because we were sitting next to each other one time. It was one time, but I had to log her in, and I didn't know her password, she wrote it down for me. And then, being the friend that I am, because I don't like for people to think, okay, you got mine, now let me get yours. I mean, I don't like, how I'm trying to say this, I don't like for people to be like, I always feel like, okay, what is it? I don't want people to feel like I'm taking advantage of them because I got something of theirs, even though I could easily rip the paper up, throw the paper away, give it back to her. But at this point, I'm pretty sure people, you know how people be, like, I'm pretty sure she'll feel like, oh, she probably wrote that down so much, she probably just joined it. Because, you know, that's how I probably think. So I do how, you know how I would think. So my thinking is give her my stuff because I don't want her to feel like she got my stuff, and I don't, you know, she might do anything. If she do something, she don't know that I got my stuff. I don't even have her stuff, you know. So I mean, it was too trusting of me, but at the same time, she wouldn't do it. I mean, you know, you're not supposed to think like that. You're not supposed to think somebody who you think would. But I mean, like, for real though, she wouldn't. But I mean, she kind of was probably moved first, but she wouldn't do that unless I tempted her, like, did something for her to do that. So yeah, but y'all ain't never do that for her to do that. But yeah, this kind of like a story time, like, telling y'all stuff, stories and stuff. But what's next? Yeah, don't be sharing no passwords, no combinations, no none of that. I mean, excuse me, I wouldn't share a locker. It's just because, like I said, people be messy, all that stuff. You don't want nothing to be missing. And, like, if you got your own, because I'm telling you, at this point in high school, we get rowdy. Like, that's y'all know. I mean, middle school too, but in high school, I feel like it's worse. But, oh, yeah. It's not supposed to be worse. Middle school is the time for that. But, if something goes missing in your locker, that's your problem. If something goes missing in you and your friend's locker, it's what happened. You don't remember doing anything with it. They didn't do anything with it. Now it's a whole argument. You know, I just wouldn't even go for all of that, especially like in high school. Because at this point, we're too old for that anyway. That's all cute and games when you're in middle school and all of that. But high school, I wouldn't. What else? Talk about. Pack your lunch. If you gonna complain about school food, pack your own lunch. Like, I just couldn't stand people. I mean, I pack my lunch here and there because, y'all, I don't really eat in school. Like, I ain't the type that, I mean, I used to pack a little light lunch, whatever. But to be honest, my lunch was more so snacks through the day. Because I don't eat already. So, like, really eating, I ain't really eating. But yeah, y'all, if y'all knew me in Midland Valley, I never went, maybe, no, I said maybe, I probably have. I think I have, like, because I'm wild, wild line. But I know for breakfast, I did go through the line one day because we wanted to go out to the buses. We were trying to be slick. Because me and one of my friends, me and one of somebody who was cool, we was car riders and we wanted to go with the bus riders. So we went to the cafeteria. We got our food and sat down for a little minute. Then we went outside with the buses. Simple. But y'all, that was one time I did that. I think I did that another time because I remember going through it late. But other than that, I don't too much remember going through a lunch line. Because I didn't. I didn't eat what was what I want. If I did, I probably wouldn't go get somebody else some food. But other than that, I don't remember. But, at Aiken High, y'all, that same, I don't even know why I just only stay in Midland Valley. Because at Aiken High, it was the same way. Y'all, I barely, like, towards the end before Corona hit is when I started going through the line. Because they would have pizza with the sausages on it. Ooh, something about them little pieces that was good. I only wanted them pieces. If they ain't had them pieces, I was mad. And if somebody had, like, Jack, I'm just letting everything out. Well, I mean, shoot, listen to the story. Hop in. But, at this point, I'm going to just keep talking. But one of my friends, Jazz, with dreads, because got to be specific. I said specific. Oh, my gosh. Specific. Because I hate when people say specific. Like, been whom? Jazz. So, she used to, like, for some reason, she would get lucky. She would always get what I want. So, we would trade here and there. But, Jazz, she was going on. Because, like, sometimes you want to be stingy, and I ain't like that. But who, like, really, my lunch was them darn venomous. That's what really got me. Aiken High took all my freaking money. Like, I probably spent, I know I ain't hit no 100. I know I ain't hit 80. Maybe 40, maybe 30. Maybe more than that. Probably, 60, because I used to buy other people drinks. Yeah. Don't do that. Don't do that. I mean, some people buy me drinks too. Like, that's cool, to be honest. Because I used to buy a drink almost every day. But people be like, can you buy me a drink? I'll buy you a drink tomorrow. That's cool. But I used to, ooh. And then sometimes I would get two drinks in one day. Because, y'all, them little drinks would go by fast. Like, especially when I was thirsty. Them little sugar-free drinks. Then Diana gonna tell me to stop drinking them. So I used to get whatever. It was something I started getting. It was so sweet. It was so nasty though, but it was sweet. I tolerated it because it was so freaking sweet, but it was nasty. I wouldn't drink it as fast as I would drink blue Gatorades. But yeah. So that's the end of this advice video. It wasn't much. It was a little more of me just talking to y'all. But I hope you enjoyed it. Enjoy high school, your first year. I hope you have a good tomorrow. I hope your day was good today, because this video probably gonna drop late. I might drop it early, I don't know. But I hope wherever you at in your school, I hope it goes good.